Let's look at this simple workflow I tried for changing the background of a video having a human subject. And it worked. The original video is on the left, and the result is on the right. These are the frames with noise created in the process of changing the background. The workflow is simple, and I am not using this torch compile, but you can have it connected if you want to use it. I am using SDPA to compare the generation time with Sage compile. 6 seconds for one step and 116 seconds on my 4060 Ti 16 GB. The video link will be in the description to set up Sage attention. And it worked without a prompt previously. Now I will try again using Sage compile. It takes around 4 seconds for each step, and the entire process was completed within 50 seconds. The result looks okay. It is not bad for short and quick changes. The workflow is fast because of the model I am using. This UniLumos 2.1 is a small 1.3 billion parameter model, and the size of the model is less than 3 gigabytes. Which means this should work even on smaller graphic cards. Links to the necessary files are given. This text encoder can be downloaded from here. And this is the smaller text encoder I am using right now. Next is the LoRa. I am using the cause video LoRa. Links to multiple other LoRa are given. And this is the direct download link to the LoRa I am using. Links to the VAE are also given with the VAE I am using right now. So after having all the files, you need to upload a video of the foreground, a video with the subject, and then the background. The height and the width of the background are set here. The same goes for the foreground video. The logic here is simple. The background should be of the same size or larger than the foreground video. Both of these videos are the condition for generating the result. So, the VAE encodes these video frames from the pixel space to the latent space for the K-sampler. After VAE encodes, you can see that this condition goes to the K-sampler's image embeds. The second condition of the video generation is the text prompt, but I tried without prompts, and it works. The K-sampler processes the video, and the output is then decoded from latent space into the pixel frames with the help of VAE. And then we can see the result. These two nodes can be bypassed because they bring the original video of the subject to the final result for a side-by-side comparison. Now you should get the final result only. This is a low-resolution 16 FPS result, so I have added a few nodes to upscale the result. I copied this from the previous workflow, which was about generating a video using multiple frames. I will make the connection to upscale the result. The upscale model used here is given on the left. You can download the model from this link. And when you run the workflow with these nodes active, the result video should be twice the size of the original video's resolution. But still, this will be a 16-frame video. So these two nodes can be used, and more frames will be added, and you should get a 32 FPS video. This is a simple workflow to upscale the result, and it works even on smaller graphic cards. I will be making a dedicated video on upscale later, which should enhance the quality of the result as well. The upscale took around a minute, and this is the result. This should look a lot smoother as there are twice the frames than it was before. I will be checking if it works with a car or any other objects. As of now, I need to work on a different project, hence ending up with a quick video and the workflow. Make sure to keep the frame rate similar for both the uploaded video. And the frame load cap should be at 80 frames, because the WAN model may give bad results with longer videos. Process multiple batches of 80 frames when working with long videos. 80 frames for the first time, and then for the second batch, skip the first 80 frames, and then the node should take the next 80 frames. Make sure to update the WAN video wrapper as there are new nodes added for this model to work, or else you will get a missing node error when using this workflow. The result generated looks good. The background around the woman's hair is replaced flawlessly. And this can be achieved even on a smaller graphics card, which makes the model practical to many users. So that was it in the video. This should help some viewers. I hope you have an excellent day.